walk. Gonna pan around. Nice and smooth. Perfectly balanced. I'm using a stabilizer here, a video camera stabilizer specifically. It's a Manfrotto 585 3-in-1 Moto Steady. And if you happen to use a video recorder, like in your hand, you may consider picking up a stabilizer. Now, the reason why I went with this one is because it's a 3-in-1, as I mentioned before. Here we go, the regular stabilizer mode. So I've got it counterbalanced, so everything moves smoothly. Of course, as long as I'm recording, I have the camera on. I can switch it to shoulder support simply by pressing this little button in, flipping the camera around, and turning it on again. And now I've got shoulder support. See how it locks right in there? Perfect. Seamless. So I'm not jittery with my hand. So my videos, if I'm planning on panning, are going to come out a lot more smooth. Consider using a stabilizer. Even if you're standing still, you're still jittering. I mean, you really don't want to carry a tripod with you wherever you go, do you? And even if you do have a tripod, nothing is going to beat the natural motion of your arm or your hand. Unless, of course, you've got, you know, money to burn. But let's say you do want a tripod. Okay, so what we're going to do is turn this into a tripod. Give me a second. Pull down that trigger and lock it down. Look at that. Tripod. Tripod mode. Look at that. Perfect. Of course, I don't have it, you know, exactly balanced at this point in time, but I'm just showing you how you can flip between stabilizer to shoulder support to tripod. 3-in-1. Less than $100. I got it on sale, had a coupon for it. In case you wanted some kind of a stabilization tool, some stabilizer for your video or even camera usage, just like still camera usage, if you're looking for a stabilizer, then consider getting the Manfrotto 585 3-in-1 Moto Steady. I've been wanting one of these for a while, you know, since I was especially starting to do a lot more recording of video, walking around, and then noticing that, you know, even with optical image stabilization, it still wasn't as steady as I really wanted it to be. It's easy to flip between modes, and then once you find the perfect counterbalance, because that's important, every camera is going to have a different weight, and you definitely want to find the perfect counterbalance for your particular camera. But then once you do find it, then, you know, you can keep it going, and keep it steady, and keep things flowing smooth, and then when your shoulder gets tired, or if you want more shoulder support, fine, it's just as easy, flip it around. Takes like a minute to learn. It's not that difficult. It's not a very mechanical piece of equipment. And you can spend, you know, a lot of money on a video stabilizer. There's no need to spend $3,000 if all you're going to get, you know, out of it is $100 worth, and that's how much, well, thereabout, it cost me. Actually, it cost me a little less than $100. If you're looking for this, let me know. My email address is chris@perillo.com. We'll probably be posting the coupons for it on my corresponding blog post for this particular review at chris.perillo.com. And then, you're welcome to join us in our community of geeks. We have some budding videographers there at geeks.perillo.com. And then you're also welcome to join us in the chat room, which is streaming live 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, with a live video feed that is pretty much this angle that you are looking at right now on a tripod, not, you know, on a stabilizer, because it's stabilized, it's not moving. You know what I'm saying? But hopefully you do. Anyway, you're welcome to stop by. We're typically talking tech at live. .perillo.com. We'll eat you later.